Hello students, how are you all? Welcome to our science class section 18. How are you? I hope you all are fine and good by the grace of God. Have you remembered what we have learnt in the previous classes? Previous class, we have learnt about shapes and patterns. Tell any two shapes. Square, rectangle, very good. Circle, oval, very good. Diamond, arrow, very good children. You all remember very well. Today in our class, we are going to learn about source of water and uses of water. Source of water and uses of water. We drink water every day. Have you thought how this water is coming? From where we are getting our water? Yeah, we use water from bottles. We'll purchase from shops and we'll drink. But these are the sources which you know. Today in this class, we are going to learn about the sources, very different types of sources of water we are going to learn in this class. Source is the origin, how we are getting water. We are going to learn all these things. The first and main natural source of water is rain. Everyone can see what is happening. It is raining. What is happening? It is raining. Yeah, rain is the natural source of water. Through rain, we can get a plenty of water. So, in our rainy seasons, we should save our water for the summer seasons. Can anyone spell the word rain? R-A-I-N. Rain. What is the spelling of rain? R-A-I-N. Rain. What is the spelling of rain? R-A-I-N. Rain. While you are learning, take your science note. Now, this is 3. What we are learning? This is lesson 3. Put lesson 3. Sources of water and uses of water, and put number 1 and write rain. What is the next source? What is this? Well, in your villages you may have seen this well. It is a artificial thing built to collect water in ground. They'll dig the ground and they build a well, and through that well they'll save water for further purpose. This is a place where they'll save water in villages. Still some home they have well. Using this bucket, they'll fetch the water from inside to outside. But some well naturally has a source of water from underground. There will be a fountain. From that, they'll get water. Or else this rainwater will save in this well and they'll use for further purpose. The spelling of well is W-E-L-L. Well, what is the spelling of well? W-E-L-L. Well, put number 2 and write W-E-L-L. Well, read along with me. W-E-L-L. Well, the next source. Lake. What is the next source? Lake. These are the water bodies in a ground will be surrounded. This is a place where water will stagnate, but around the water, the surroundings will be the land area. Among the land area, some part the water will stagnate. That is called as lake. These are the natural thing which is formed by the creation of God. This is called lake. This is called lake. If you see water and it is surrounded by the living areas or non-living areas, that is, if it is surrounded by the ground, it is called lake. A water will be there. The water will be surrounded by the land. It is called lake. It is called lake. What is the spelling of lake? L-A-K-E, lake. What is the spelling of lake? L-A-K-E, lake. What is the spelling of lake? L-A-K-E, lake. What is next? Can anyone tell what is this? What is this? This is steam. This is steam. This is steam. Small water body. Lake will be in the larger area. Steam will be in the smaller area. The spelling of stream is S-T-R-E-A-M. What is the spelling of steam? S-T-R-E-A-M. Steam. S-T-R-E-A-M. E-A-M, steam. These are the narrow path water bodies. The larger path is called lake. The narrow path is called steam. Very good. The spelling of steam is S-T-R-E-A-M, steam. Shall we move on to the next? This is called river. This is called river. You can see some shape like an S shape it is going. A large water body. In aspect of length, there will be a larger area. All these lakes join together and form a river. What it will form? A river. This is called a river. What is this? River. A larger water body is called river. The spelling of river is R-I-V-E-R. R-I-V-E-R, right? R-I-V-E-R, river. The next, dam. What is this? Dam. In case the water is overflowing in the lake, river or stream, some waters are collected for the future purpose, for the further purpose or for the future. This is a construction they build. It's an artificial. How we have learnt, well will dig a ground and will build a well. In the same way, dam will construct a dam for saving purpose. To save water, will build dam and will collect and will use for future. The spelling of dam is D-A-M. D-A-M. The spelling of dam is D-A-M. The spelling of dam is D-A-M. Shall we learn the next? It's sea. What is this? Sea. It is a sea. It is a non-measurable water body. Very larger water body is called sea. All rivers, lake, stream join together, flow, and it is called sea. The spelling of sea is S-E-A. The spelling of sea is S-E-A. It is a larger water body. Larger means big. You may have seen many seas. Among this is one. The spelling of sea is S-E-A. Sea. The next water body is falls. The next water body is falls. Why it is called as falls? The water is falling from up. The water is falling from up. These are the things naturally formed. It is a falls. This also one of the water body. We use water from this. The spelling of falls is FALLS. The spelling of falls is FALLS. The spelling of falls is FALLS. This is falls. Children, till now we have learnt about well, rain, river, stream, lake, sea, dam, and now it is falls. These are the few information which is required up to your knowledge. If you want to know further, you will learn on your bigger classes. These are the some of the sources of water. Now we are going to learn using this source how we are going to use the water. So now we are going to learn about uses of water. For what purpose you will use water? You will drink, you will wash clothes, you will clean your space and many things. Now we are going to learn one by one for what it is using. The first use of water is bathing. We take bath every day. You should take bath every day. Water is used to take bath. We use water for our bathing. We use water for our bathing. How many of you took bath today? Yeah, you all are very good children. You will take bath every day. It is called bathing. We use water for bathing. Second one, drinking. How many glass of water you should drink a day? At least you should drink 8 glasses of water every day. How many glasses of water? 8 glasses of water every day. Next, wiping. We'll wipe our mirror, we'll wipe our tables. Many things will wipe and will clean. For that we use our water. What he is doing is wiping. The spelling of wiping is W-I-P-I-N-G. Wiping. What is doing? What she is doing? Cooking. We use water for cooking. The spelling of cooking is C-O-O-K-I-N-G. Cooking. These are the actions which they are doing. So we are calling as bathing, wiping, drinking and cooking. What she is doing? She is cooking. We use water for cooking. Then water is used for swimming. Water is used for swimming. What is doing is swimming. Water is used for swimming. The spelling of swimming is S-W-I-M-M-I-N-G. S-W-I-M-M-I-N-G. After learning swimming only, you should swim in the water. Without learning, you should not swim in the water. The next one, washing. What is the next? Washing. We use our water for washing our clothes, utensils and etc. What? For what we are using? For washing. What is the spelling? W-A-S-H-I-N-G. W-A-S-H-I-N-G. Washing. We use for washing. What is next? Cleaning. What is next? Cleaning. We'll use water for cleaning a area or a thing or etc. We'll use water for cleaning. The spelling is C-L-E-A-N-I-N-G. Cleaning. C-L-E-A-N-I-N-G. Cleaning. Next, for what we'll use? For mopping. In your book it is printed wrong. We use water for mopping. We use water for mopping. M-O-P-P-I-N-G. Mopping. These are the few major use of water. Water is also used for many other purposes, but these are the very basic things which we use every day. Today in our class, we have learnt about the source of water, the use of water. Kindly write in your notes and send to me. See you, children. Before ending our class, shall we pray? Dear Jesus, thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe and secure to learn the source of water and the uses of water. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us with rain and help us to save the water for the further purpose. Please be with us, guide us, bless our parents and our teachers and our school family. Till we meet again, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, children. Thank you all. Write and send to me now WhatsApp. Thank you.